This is an origami generated by an AI. It is still a simple origami with not too many features on it, but the amazing part is that it learned how to create a crease pattern that would mold into an origami by looking at some examples of what is and what is not an origami. It all started 2 weeks ago. I had a random thought. What if we could have an AI that could understand what a crease pattern is and generate the origami we want? I'm quite sure this is possible. We have AI doing crazier things, so it's just a matter of time. But as I couldn't find anything being done in this area, I gave it a shot. Now, stay with me in this journey. To start training my AI, I separated some of my crease patterns I created in the past, and made a few more, especially the easy and the classic ones. Next, I created another 100 things that looks like a foldable crease pattern, but it's not really an origami, or at least not a flat foldable crease pattern. The next thing was to give all these crease patterns to the AI and ask it to learn how to differentiate between an origami and not an origami. And it actually worked really well, because with just a few hundreds of origamis in the training set, the AI got really good already, learning to guess it correctly over 90% of the time. So I made a new test. I created a population of random lines and asked the AI to select the ones that he thinks it's more likely to be an origami. Next, he mixed the genes to create offsprings, make a new population, and repeat the process until he gets an origami that he is certain that it is an origami. And after a few generations, the AI said, "Okay, I got it. I made the perfect origami with 100% certainty that this is a foldable crease pattern." Okay, I don't know what I expected. It was obviously not going to be that easy, but I was hoping that it would at least understand that the lines must be connected. So it is a wonder that it can guess what is and what is not an origami if it doesn't understand even that. Anyway, this first step made me realize one thing. It makes no sense to work with random lines. Let's work only with connected lines. So let's be more specific. I filtered the training set, the testing set, changed the randomizer to make only connected lines, trained the AI, and... Well, this is quite obviously something that no one would fold. I mean, look at those clumped up lines, you can't fold it. Okay, time to improve the techniques. It seems like the AI, even though it's good at telling me what is a crease pattern with 93% of precision, still does it by analyzing some weird patterns. One way to improve the AI is to apply some filters in the crease pattern. Instead of just showing all the lines, we pass other relevant informations, so it will pay attention to some parameters that might be important. For example, how many points has only one connection? How many has two, three, four, 12, more? How many points are on the border? How many are in each section? What are the angles between the lines? And so on. And after all these filters, the AI got to a 99.7% of precision in identifying if a set of lines is a crease pattern or not. So I tried to generate another crease pattern again. But this time, the computer was actually having a hard time to get a valid crease pattern. After 10,000 generations trying to find a solution, I checked what was going on. And the best result it could get was this. Can you see it? The AI was actually getting close. You can see that it's trying to find symmetry here. Here you can see that it found the concept of a rabbit ear fold. It also figured out that every point in the middle must have an even number of lines connected to it. So why it couldn't find a solution? Well, this one was actually my mistake. The way I programmed it didn't give it a good remove line option. So it was trying to clump up the lines into the shape it wanted, but it would really never get into a solution. So I implemented a mutation possibility to just remove a line and join the points. And oh boy, the AI got really clever and got this solution. You know, that's the problem with AI. It doesn't understand your feelings. They only want to achieve their task and it will use the tools you give it in the most effective way. Yeah, you can fold it, you're right, but that's not what I wanted. Well, let's try again just to be sure it wasn't just bad luck. Okay, this one is a little bit better. At least it achieved symmetry. The point here has 4 lines connected to it, but... I limited the amount of times the AI can use the razor. I did all the process one more time, and I finally got these results. You can see that it is still trying to be lazy by either leaving one side completely empty, or just making a single line to correct the middle point. Still, you can see some attempts to find symmetry, and just a note, I never passed any filter to say if the origami is symmetrical or not. It just figured out by looking at the examples that most origamis are symmetrical. Well, if the AI was lazy to make the symmetry, we can just cut some slack and reflect what he created on one side to the other side. And I was really curious to see what shapes it would fold into, especially this one that got some really curious shapes. So I reflected it, adjusted the mountain and valley folds, and this was the result. In one quick glance, I noticed that it was a single fold away from becoming a whale. So I added this one fold, finished shaping it, and voila! The first AI-generated origami. I tried to fold the other crease patterns, but it didn't really become anything, although you could fold it. And that was it, my journey so far in trying to create an AI-generated origami. This was a one-week project, so it's still very crude, with several bumps in the process. I know there are several ways to improve this project, like instead of creating a random origami, it should have an input, like a drawing, and it would try to make the origami with the same shape. Or separate the AI to create a specific category of origamis. Well, there are lots and lots of ideas, but each project takes a lot of time. So if possible, I would like to invite you to become a channel member to help me keep creating these contents. Also, don't forget to click on the like button and to share this video, it helps me a lot. And as always, be good to the others and hey, really, don't forget to be good to yourself. Thanks a lot for watching this video. See you, bye bye.